Mini chapter 79, Hatred Across the LA River, a Cruel and Stupid World. Jaymi lowers the lid of his laptop, slides it aside, and resumes his former attentiveness, looking up and out and down from his bedroom terrace, slanting his attention back into Evelyn, Shigem, and Kim, who are still hunkered down near the LA River, peeking out from their hide. He sees what has been brewing there in his absence. Unknown to the street queens of Violet Street, the Bangdead Trust for the Family has started to take an avid interest in this family, whose beauty so electrifies this grimy corner of the city. The Trust is an organization with the fire of traditional values in its veins. It isn't based in the immediate neighborhood, being located on the opposite side of the LA River's desolate width of smooth concrete, straight across from here, but it happens to occupy the only premises whose windows are positioned at the correct angle to see straight into the circular end of this storm drain. Hidden behind those reflective windows across the river on Mission Road, the Trust's director has thus been able to watch the Queen's daily lives in detail, has chosen to watch them at some length, and as a result feels compelled to help repair society's fabric. To which end, he forms an intention that this home in the storm drain will be systematically blowtorched in the small hours of an imminent summer night as an act of social cleansing. Subcontracted by the Trust, the resultant blowtorching is efficient, professional, and anonymous. No person is burned. The dozen or so people who happen to be in the storm drain when justice descends, most of these being resident queens, along with one or two guests, are simply overpowered without warning by a well-planned posse of experienced manpower with half-concealed faces. The dozen or so are then forced outside, while this home and all its residents' belongings are incinerated. The posse's departure is as fast and clean as its arrival. It is spirited away in an unmarked van, whose speeding engine noise disappears inside a minute, westwards and away through the quiet streets of downtown. The victims of the crime huddle at the top of the dry concrete slope of the river's channel, unspeaking, some crying in silence, some staring in shock. Two blocks up the channel, cars move across the 7th Street Bridge, from right to left or from left to right, spanning the river and the railroad tracks on either side of it, indifferent and bland, as if nothing has happened. While the group watches, smouldering containers of makeup, of many hues and consistencies, pop open in succession and flare alight inside the storm drain's newly blackened circle. As the oil content in the lipstick or eyeshadow or eyeliner catches fire, shooting puffs of multicolored smoke into the warm night air. From outside her head, the anger or despair in each member of the group may only be guessed at. But it's likely that in her own particular way, there by the river, she'll be having one of her life's clearest perceptions of the cruelty and stupidity that fill the design of the world. At the parapet of his balcony in the gods, high on the uppermost of the three terraces that wrap around the house on Electra Drive, Jaymi catches the pain that flowers in the dozen perceptions huddled down there on the concrete river. And just for a moment, he feels he can almost hear an answer to it, flowing in somehow, like a grand, endless echo through the silence of the night air. A chorus of other pain in other people targeted as freaky around the world.